child, you're headed for heaven. And so all of your life, that means that things are going to go well for you. Again, kind of difficult to trust, isn't it? Wasn't it for Joseph? Remember the story of Joseph? 20 years, about. 20 years, Joseph's life, I don't think it could have gotten any worse. Joseph's brothers hated him. They wanted to murder him. They threw him in that cistern. Then they sold him into slavery. He gets to Egypt, and he's probably thinking, hey, this is great. I got away from my brothers. No, gets worse. Potiphar's wife's after him. Remember, he gets thrown into the slammer. But God knew what he was doing, didn't he? God was molding and shaping Joseph so that he could be second in command of all of Egypt. Joseph was probably wondering, you know, what's going on? God was using him to save the people of Israel and the promise of the Savior through Israel. You ever think about Moses? Do you know for Moses, 80 years, Moses spent like 8 decades separated from his mom, his family members, his countrymen, and he ends up in the sticks, the middle of nowhere. He's like in that Sinai Peninsula where there's nothing green. It's all dirt and sticks and rocks. Talk about boring and lonely. Did God know what he was doing with Moses? Yeah, he did. He was molding and shaping Moses to effect the greatest deliverance in all of Old Testament history. And finally, people, what about the cross? Have you ever thought about that? What a disaster. From a human point of view, you've got the most innocent person there ever was dying on the cross, suffering hell for all of mankind. You've got Jesus, who's the embodiment of love, being rejected by God and his own people. But God knew what he was doing, didn't he? I mean, you look at that whole scene from a human point of view, again, it couldn't be worse, but God used it to offer your forgiveness, to earn your forgiveness. God used the cross of Christ to pay for all of your sins, to give you hope and joy and an eternal future. The cross of Christ reminds us that God always knows what he's doing, and he always leads us in a way that's best for us. So brothers and sisters in Christ, if you feel like a polar bear in a glass enclosure, you're crying all the time, you're depressed, you wonder what's going on with my life, it's in tatters. I feel guilty all the time. I've got these problems that seem to be insurmountable. I don't know which way I should turn. Remember, fellow Christians, in Jesus Christ, your King, everything's going to be fine. Everything's going to be okay. Because in Jesus, you've got a King who absolutely guarantees you he's going to be with you every step of the way. He's your King. You look outside, it looks all chaotic. He's in charge. Don't worry about it. And right now, people, if your life seems to be all wrong, Jesus, your King, promises that he will definitely make sure it ends up just right. Trust him. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, will keep our hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Amen. Let us rise. We join together in our confession of faith, which is the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate,
was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
You may be seated. Bow our heads in prayer. Lord God, Heavenly Father, you lift us up and have blessed us with the ministry and work of this congregation. We thank you for our pastors, those in positions of leadership in our congregation, teachers in our school who nurture us spiritually. We also thank you for each and every member here in this congregation who uses their spiritual gifts to bless others. We thank you for the rich fellowship we enjoy with one another. And today we give you our tithes and offerings to support the ministry and work of this church and our community and throughout the world. Bless these gifts and use them to your glory. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. In our prayers today, we want to remember Barbara Lovett. Her brother passed away, Gilbert Crane. Passed away. We also want to remember one of our missionaries. Again, we're celebrating Befriend a Missionary Month. For this Sunday, we're going to remember Pastor Jordan Bentz and his wife Laura and their mission work and the efforts of their congregation, the Vine Lutheran Church in Joplin, Missouri. We pray. O Christ, our King, you have delivered us from the domain of darkness and transferred us into your kingdom. In you we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. Bless all Christian homes, that as the children of your kingdom, we would grow in the fear of the Lord, honor your name, serve you faithfully, and walk in your way undismayed by the prosperity of the wicked, until all is revealed at the last day. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
O Christ, our King, let the earth fear you, and all the world's inhabitants stand in awe of you. For you alone are King of kings and Lord of lords. Preserve those who fear you and serve you in the midst of this fallen world, and maintain good government among us. Nevertheless, come quickly, Lord Jesus, for your kingdom is not of this world, and our citizenship is with you in paradise. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
O Christ, our King, have mercy and deliver us from evil. For our sins we've deserved only just condemnation and calamity. Yet you have remembered us from your cross and given us access to the Father in your name. Deliver the troubled, the sick, and the dying, and preserve them in your kingdom forever. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
O Christ, our King, in your blood the saints of all ages wash their robes and find entrance to paradise with you. Bring us also with them out of death and the grave and into resurrection and eternal life at the last day, when we will see you crowned with glory. For you are the Lamb who was slain, and now lives and reigns with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Dear Lord Jesus, we further pray for Barbara Lovett and the whole family upon the loss of her brother Gilbert. Lord, whenever a loved one dies, there's that pain of separation, that ache that's in our hearts, when we no longer see that loved one here on this earth. We ask, Lord Jesus, that you would be especially with Barbara and the whole family at this difficult time. Assure them once again that you are the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, who absolutely guarantees that you're going to be with each and every one of us. You bolster our faith through your word. Be with Barbara and the whole family. Strengthen them in their faith life. Direct their eyes to the empty tomb, to the resurrection, to the eternal life that you've promised those who trust in you. Comfort them, dry their tears with your beautiful promises of grace, mercy, and eternal life. Heavenly Father, we also rejoice today that you've written our names in the book of life and given us the new birth of water and the word. We especially ask that you would be with Pastor Jordan Bentz and his wife Laura. Bless the efforts of the Vine Lutheran Church to reach out to the lost in Joplin, Missouri. All these things, Jesus, we pray in your name. Amen. We join together now also in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen.
Some repetition in the blessing song, so after the worship team sings through the blessing and amen once, feel free to join us.
Morning once again, everybody. Great to have you here with us today. A few announcements we'd like to highlight. We've issued a couple of divine calls. One has been extended to Mr. Daniel Johnson to serve as our principal. He's still deliberating that call. Another one was extended to Ms. Jordan Paustian to teach seventh grade. She has returned that call, so we'll gather together next couple of weeks for an additional call meeting to call it another time for seventh grade teacher. Also, Thanksgiving worship's coming this week, so you've got two options. There's a 6:30 p.m. service. It's Wednesday at the North Campus Good Shepherds. Or you can come here 9 a.m. Thursday, November 24th. Same service, same sermon. Pastor Wempner will be preaching for both services. For the midweek Advent services, that's coming up next Sunday's first Sunday in Advent, and then the midweek services. Good news for difficult days is the theme. We're in a rotation. You see it there. There's sign-up sheets. There's going to be supper offered at Good Shepherd's between services there. So if you want to help out with that, if you want to attend those, the sign-up sheets are on a table to the left. And also some information about Advent by Candlelight coming up. Again, North Campus, Good Shepherd's Fellowship Hall. That is November 27th, next Sunday, 6 p.m. Information on the table. There's also devotional booklets for Advent that you can take. Please take one of those home for your devotional life. And finally, we did that Lamb of God B-Team tournament, boys and girls. Man, that's a ton of work. So thank you to those who put in the time to serve. We really appreciate it. Those who donated all that stuff, and we really do appreciate it. Both teams, girls and boys, really had good games, were competitive. They fell a bit short this year, but they did a good job. So thank you, everybody, for that. Lord's blessings to all of you, and we'll see you again next time.